700 people at breakfast this morning. It was a wonderful event. They're going to speak on behalf of their class. They're going to do a commencement address, and they're going to do it combined, I believe. I'm not sure of the order, so I'm going to call all three of them up at one stage. Again, it's my privilege to introduce Amy Eubank, Meg Fitzgerald, and Ella Perlman.
Second, and I apologize advise Mr. Warman for 4 years of this, but fake it till you make it, or at least until the next measure. If you act like you know what you're doing and that you belong, one day you will truly do just that. And last but not least, remember that you are loved, if not by the entire world, then certainly by myself and those who are sitting shoulder to shoulder with today.
They say you may forget someone, but you will never forget the way that they treat you. This is a sentiment I have learned to embrace over the years, particularly within the class of 2016. I might not remember every face in those 80 chairs, and I might not remember those 80 names in the future, but I will remember what the class of 2016 gave me and how they treated me. They have given me a support system and an extended family, a group of people I know I can always rely on, and a group that I can't wait to see succeed in the future. This group of 80 students is going to be very successful in the future, and that's what I'm looking forward to the most. Now, for a family so special and priceless and so important to me, it's pretty hard to figure out what to say to you. But as I sit in my fourth period religion class trying to scribble something down and write a speech worthy enough to address you all with, I have come up with one major idea: success. Personally, I know we are all going to succeed far beyond our expectations. The 80 of us have amazing potential, and I believe that we could all truly accomplish some unforgettable things. Thomas Edison once said, "If we did the things we are capable of, we would astound ourselves." In order to build your future, I believe that we need three things. You must work hard, be comfortable with the unknown, and never ever quit. We have the skills, the faith, and the knowledge within us to make a change in the world. And more than anything else, the drive to. You can't climb the ladder of success with your hands in your pockets. And I believe that so many of us won't try to climb a ladder in that manner. The most valuable result of one's hard work is the knowledge that you gain in the process. We are all born ignorant, but one must work to remain stupid, said Benjamin Franklin. And with the class of 2016, I believe that this really rings true. Every single one of us has the drive and motivation to develop genius, as well as the common sense to not remain dumb. As we all know, genius is 1% talent and 99% hard work. You know that uncertainty that you all feel now, the worry about what will happen next year and how you will cope? That uncertainty will never go away. The challenge now is to make that uncertainty your friend. What is going to happen to all of us in 3 months is one of the scariest things that most of us has encountered up to this point. And certainly the future is a terrifying concept for those of us who don't have a clue what to expect. Although, the sooner that we accept the unknown and become more comfortable with that uncertainty, the sooner we will be able to be more at peace. And we must never forget that none of us are alone. Like I mentioned earlier, the 80 of you have given me an extended family and a support system. Even though most of us are venturing into the unknown next year, none of us will be alone, since we are all stumbling into that same dark and scary place together. Nothing is really over until the moment you stop trying. This is one of the greatest pieces of advice that I have ever been given to help inspire me to not give up. With strength, faith, and perseverance, each one of us can accomplish any goal that we set our mind to. Whether our goal is as minuscule as waking up for an 8 a.m. class every day next year, or something as extraordinary as a medical breakthrough, any goal that a member of the class of 2016 seeks to accomplish, I know will be accomplished. Sometimes we'll be knocked down in the years to come. Maybe we won't land that job we wanted so badly, or we'll fail another calculus exam, or maybe we'll make a decision that we aren't proud of. But what is more important than any of those shortcomings is the way that we react to them. You can't control what happens to you, but you can control how you react to it. One failure or mistake does not define us, and we have the ability to grow from each one of these missteps, taking what positivity we can from the situation and learning from it. Failure isn't a bad thing, it only means that you're trying. In the wake of the Blitz on Britain in World War II, after relentless bombings on major cities, Prime Minister Winston Churchill said this: "Never give in, never give in, never, never, never. In nothing, great or small, large or petty, never give in, except to convictions of honor and good sense. Never yield to force, never yield to the apparently overwhelming might of the enemy." Mr. Churchill teaches us a very valuable lesson with these words. He faced one of the most terrifying forces of the war, the Nazi regime, but he never gave up and he never gave in to their force. and in 1945, his dreams and determination came to fruition in the fall of the Nazis. Now, we might not be taking on fascist dictators in our futures, but we will be taking on battles and obstacles along the way, to which we must never succumb. Never give in and trust that your hard work and determination will show its good karma. The class of 2016 is unique. The 80 of us are not only spectacularly bright and promising as a class, but we are close and bonded like no one could ever imagine. Facing joyous times and times of loss alike, we have grown to become one family. One family that we will always have and can always count on. Thank you for all being my family and giving me something that I can never thank you all enough for. The memories I have shared with you all have shaped me and made me the person that I am today. I hope for nothing but the best for each and every one of you, because we hold great potential for this world. And in some final parting words, I wish that your futures be bright and your hydro flasks be full. Thank you.
My 4 years at Central can be defined by a series of things that I have given and received from this community within which I am so lucky to have fostered my education. When I was named valedictorian and given the opportunity to speak today, I was incredibly honored, but honestly a little surprised, because this group of graduates in front of me is truly an amazing one, defined by a myriad of academic, athletic, and extracurricular successes, and this title and this honor is one that I can honestly share with all of you. To give and to receive are symbiotic. One cannot exist without the other. In our time together, the members of this class have learned how to do exactly that. The clearest example of this resides in times of devastating loss. When Noah and George were taken from our lives, we were able to provide for each other a support system to rely on. When I look out on all of you today, I see the absence of two chairs, the absence of two people who should have shared this day with us. There is no way to find closure, no way to explain the tragedies that we have suffered through, and we are left to remember the small stuff, like George's shy smile and the way Noah's face got really, really red when he was embarrassed. When I look out on all of you today, I see a group of the strongest young women, men and women that I know, a group that knows so much about love and loss, and in our heartbreak, we were able to learn how to love and rely on each other. I feel grateful and honored to have been touched by the lives of our beloved Noah and our sweet George. Yet, somehow, selfishly, it is the small losses in our everyday lives that seem to have that devastating illusion about them, as if it is the end of the world as we know it. Whether it be the misplacement of our keys, a low grade on a test, or the loss of one crucial divisional tennis match. Due to very recent experience, I have found that it is through these small defeats that we are able to find gratitude. With just a small shift in perspective, it is easy to see that yes, the worst is probably yet to come, but as of right now, there's so much to be grateful for. And while it's been said time and time again, it's true, we really don't know what we have until it's gone. I know that this is a lesson we have all learned far too harshly, but I urge you to consider it now. Whatever you take away from your time in this building, be grateful for the memories, the lessons, and the losses. They make us who we are both as a class and as individuals, and for that, I am grateful. If Central has taught me one thing, it's that you can definitely get to know a person a little too well. And as much as I cherish my classmates, our next endeavors are intended to make us feel a little uncomfortable. Soon enough, we will be totally out of our element. Whether you're 3.3 miles up the road of Rocky, 142 miles away in Montana State, or 2,060 miles away at Big Forest. It's terrifying and it's exciting all at once. My dad always says that humans stick around at home for too long. After just 2 weeks, mother birds literally shove their babies out of the nest in hopes that they can figure out how to fly on their own. And even though I know that that's all talk because my dad is probably crying harder than anyone right now, it is time for each of us to leave the nest and make something out of ourselves. At our last mass as a school on Wednesday, Father John said something that really stuck with me. He urged us to pray not just in our hearts, but with our feet. There's a strong possibility that I'm just interpreting this totally wrong, but to me, his homily was a reminder of the actual things we have to do, action we have to take. It reminded me of one of my most influential teachers' final advice to our calculus class. We are intended to do so much more than simply do. We might be remembered by the things that we do, but it is by the people we become that have the most lasting impact on others and on the world. I'm not going to pretend that I'm full of valuable life-changing advice because, just like all of you, I've still got a lot of learning to do, and I'm still going to make a lot of mistakes and hopefully learn some lessons from them. But all I can offer to you is that you stay gracious and never stop asking questions. The world is ours to discover and explore. It is with an open mind that we can realize that we have so much to learn from each other. It is with so much pride and so much love that I congratulate the graduating class of 2016. I cannot wait to see the beautiful things that you will do, and more importantly, the beautiful people you will become. The world literally does not know what is about to hit them. Thank you all.